Hey, what's happening, guys? Welcome back to another episode of Holly's Garage. We're going to be messing with this Bobcat again. Hopefully it'll be the last video for a little while. I can start working on some other stuff. But this thing, I just wanted to get it so it's reliable. And I mean, this isn't really super necessary. You can keep beating the shit out of it, I guess. But I got a lot of slop up in this front, I guess it's a bob catch or whatever, with the, where you hook the bucket. The pins and bushings are really shot. So I tried beating the shit out of the one bushing. I heated it up. I was trying to beat it out for I don't know how long. And she moved a little bit, but not enough. And so I went to Harbor Freight, went and got a 20-ton shop press, and I'm going to put that together real quick. And hopefully use it to push these bushings out. So hopefully that'll go pretty smooth. It's got to be better than just beating the hell out of it with a sledgehammer. So let's hop in it. I'll put a video up of me putting this together. I'll probably put it in this video. If you don't want to see it, just skip through it. And the rest I'll just be pushing new pins and bushings in here. Should be pretty simple. I'll just keep my fingers crossed and get them all out. Let's hop in it. So I actually have one new pin in there, just threw it in there temporarily because I was in the middle of doing this and someone came and bought something from me, so I needed to use this to move it, and that's why there's one good pin in there. Only takes a second to swap the pin out. You can see here how much slop. I mean, that's a crazy amount of slop. And so here's one of the pins too that was pulled out. You could see it's just worn so bad here. It's not supposed to look like that. it's supposed to look like this. Here's the new one. You know, there's no wear at all. And there shouldn't be here because it should be nice and tight. With the bushing, for the most part, you get a little grease in there and that's it. So yeah. That's what we're gonna do. I'll put the shop press together, and I was actually thinking about hanging the shop press so I don't have to pull these cylinders. It's not a big deal to pull them, but it's just, I don't really wanna make a mess of hydraulic fluid and all that kind of stuff. I actually did pull that one off, the lines off, and made a little bit of a mess, but I was trying to get a bottle jack behind here, chain it and push the bushing out that way, but I couldn't get the ball. My ball jack was too long, wasn't fitting in there, and that's why I started pulling lines. But this is kind of a pain in the butt. So I was thinking maybe I'll get that shop press, I'll hang it with my tractor where I need it, and I can hang it and just push these out while it's floating in the air, pretty much. And I'll give that a shot, because I am going to have to push the bushings out of the arms anyway. So I kind of have to, I'm going to have to hang that shop press one way or another sideways, because there's no way I can get these things out to drive out. But yeah, that's it. We'll give it a shot. So here's the box. They come packaged in two different boxes, and I guess this just has all the hardware, I'm sure. Looks like it. Oh, it's got this has the hardware and the jack in it. Thank you.
me being the big dummy I am, I left my microphone on, so it's dead. So I don't know how this is going to sound right now, but we'll make it work. Press up, and we'll take it and we'll put it over there by the Bobcat and try to hold it up sideways. Alright, so here's the plan. I'm going to pick this press up sideways with the tractor, hang it where I want to so I could press these bushings out, and that way I don't have to remove the cylinders, hopefully, on that Bobcat. And so we got the two, we got these pins so I can push them out. The one on the bottom here is going to be a little bit of an issue because, let me see if I can show you without making you sick. They really did a number on that one. So I'll have to cut that one off. And the other side looks okay, so I'll pop those two off. And then, you know, honestly, I'll probably just drop this whole H frame, and that'll be the best way to get this press up in there.
I'll charge my mic up, see if it works, and see how long it works for. I'm gonna cut this real quick. If I can get in there. Maybe I'll beat it straight with a hammer. So here's what the problem is. I cut it, but it's still not straight enough to pop the whole bolt out, so I'll try to. I'm just gonna try to snip that head off with the plasma cutter.
I guess this was running the whole time. I lost my mic again, so. So now what I'll do, I'll bring that shop press close, and we'll start trying to push some of these bushings out. So here's my method. Hopefully it'll work. Try to get it straight and flush too, and I'll probably just bring the forks up, or bring the forks down a hair, Then I got a ratchet strap the plates on the bottom. I got another camera battery because it died on me. These things don't last for anything, it seems like. I got some old trusty thread loosener from a pop-up that he had laying around. And I'll just hit all this stuff with it. I mean, hopefully it'll help. I already beat, well, you saw in the video earlier, but, or maybe you didn't, I might not have videoed it because the camera was bad, but I beat the hell out of that one there, and I actually got the move of the sledgehammer, so, I don't know when these bushings were changed and pins, but I'd imagine it was probably never, but, hopefully this will work and I won't have to worry about doing it again for the life that I own this machine. Alright, we'll get this bushing ready to be set in there. Here I'm just using a piece of heavy piece of steel. It's about a half inch. And I'll use that to hold the bushing. I was having a hard ass time doing that, so I'm just gonna I'm pulling the lines now, and I'll just pull the damn cylinder. Kind of frustrating because I was trying to avoid all this, and I'm gonna have to figure it out somehow because I need to get these stupid bushings out on the arm, so just frustrated. That's for sure. Now this should go smooth, I guess. I hope. Here's the rig I got. Let's see how that works.
See, look at this rusty. The rusty thing's just gonna break. But... oh. This is pushing it through. There we go.
See, I had a socket that's like about the same size. If I press it in a little further with the socket, I'd be in good, pretty good shape. I believe we got one in. I just have to make sure that that will line up with the pin, with the hole, I guess, for the pin. All right. right, now I'll check. All right, so there's a little ridge inside of the bushing, and you want that ridge to line up with this hole, because that's where the grease is going to come out. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to slide this pin into the frame, measure it, measure that, and make sure that it should line up. That way we get grease in there. We got it back done, or got it done. Well, I guess I'm not even going to put this on yet, just in case I got to beat that other one out with a sledgehammer, because I'm not sure how I'm gonna figure out how to get this out here. Unless, I mean, we can try again with the damn press, but it's just frustrating. So let's unhook the other side. So yeah, maybe I'll try. I won't put that on back on. I'll just wait. Maybe I'll do the prep. Try to rig up the press somehow. Let's pull these off. The lines off.
I got cheetah bar on it now, so I would say something's gotta give, but I guess we'll see. it at night. Keep the dog in here real quick. I don't think I had enough lip on the other side because it's all pretty well rotten. Or just so wore that there wasn't anything else. But
did it that time.
Yes, sir.
Good night.
I don't think I had enough lift on the other side because it's all pretty well rotten. Or just so wore. There wasn't anything else.
Mic was off when I was doing all that, but broke it free, and it was worth buying that Harbor Freight press because it probably just saved me that amount of money to have someone do these bushings themselves, and now I have a press, so it's handy to have. Now I'll try to get these bushings out. I'm not sure exactly how to go about doing that. So yeah, I'm not really exactly sure what to do here. I'm gonna stick the bushing in here. Just freaking try to hit it square, but I guess we'll see what happens. I don't think it's gonna work this well. It'd be nice if I could hang that piece of plate here. I don't want to round this thing off or anything. Mushroom this thing real bad. Let me get some bungee cords. I'll try to bungee cord something, some rig up some shit here. Alright, this is for sure not gonna last very long, but we'll see. I gotta hang it off somehow. Come on. moving, but it's starting to mushroom out, so it's not going to get pushed all the way in flush, which is trash. So I'm not real sure yet. Gotta press it in somehow. Or, alright, I guess I gotta buy new camera batteries because these things last like 10 minutes, if that. So, I made my own contraption here. I had a piece of all thread laying around. And these are from just, I don't even know. Trailer receiver things, and then I just cut a hole in this pipe. This is really old from when I used to like practice welding, and obviously you can see it's junk, but I'm hoping that I can put this here, which is bigger diameter than the actual bushing, tighten this nut, and it'll pull this and push the bushing through and push the old bushing out, but we'll see how that goes. See how that goes. I don't have a lot of faith in anything right now, so see how it is. Nuts gonna end up getting too long. Best setup, but I think it's gonna work. So I guess we'll see. Pushing in the majority of the way, and then I try to get the rest. Alright, we're slowly getting it, so now I think I should be able to push it in the rest of the way now. I got that one in. It's gonna be the same process for this other one, so I'm not gonna film it, but I'll get all the pins in and reinstall them, and then I'll show you the difference in the bucket movement and the play. Should be really solid now. There's a lot of other bushings that should be replaced on this machine, but I'm not getting to it right now. Rather use it a little bit and then kind of do a little bit at a time. So got them all in. I'm missing a few grease fittings, so I have some of those coming, but you can see, well, the other ones didn't even have fittings on them, the other pins, or one of them didn't. I'm missing like two grease fittings, but you can, so I didn't get to grease this one here, or this one, this whole side, but you can see this thing, it's got no play at all now. So that solved that issue. It's nice. I didn't video it, but I did a half-ass weld here. This is cracked, so I just welded it around with a stick welder real quick. Sprayed it up with some spray paint so she looks fancy. But yeah, she's ready to go now. Now I'm just wondering, there's a lot of play side to side. See how much that shakes? And it's real bad if you're running and you got a load in here or anything. It just bangs against the frame. The loader arm's banging against the frame. You can see here. And it's actually been doing it for long enough to where there's probably like a eighth of an inch shaved off of there from it wearing on this here. So, and it actually looks like this probably used to have some kind of plastic or something on it, and that's what it's built for, but there hasn't been plastic here in a long time, it doesn't look like. So that's the other thing I gotta mess with. I don't know if it's the pins or the bushings in the frame up here. So I'm just gonna keep packing this thing full of grease and running her, but it's kind of just annoying because it smacks around real bad. But yeah, besides that, she can work good now. So everything, hopefully I got the majority of the leaks. There is a leak under the seat that's real bad. And you can kind of see how that metal's all wet in there. There's a pinhole in one of the hard lines. So I gotta either go take it to a hydraulic shop or pull the line and take it there to have them make it. Or, I don't know, figure something else out. I don't think I could pull it off and weld it because I tried doing that with a high pressure line before. On my common swap truck, I tried to weld the brake line together for the hydro boost. That's a hydraulic line basically, and she didn't hold up too well.
Oh, she's solid. Well, thanks for checking out this episode of Holly's Garage. We got it done. Took like 4 hours, probably could have took less time if I had some help, and if I didn't have to do the loader arms, I mean, it would have been pretty much cake with that press. It was just lining that up, and everything was kind of a pain in the butt. Hey, Quentin, can you say hi? So that was kind of a pain, but made it work. My dad came over for like the last half hour, 45 minutes of it, probably even an hour it took me almost, and he helped me do the opposite side, so that was helpful because it made it so much smoother. I didn't have to jump in and out of the machine each time to move it, and it helped out a lot. But we got it all together, got all the leaks figured out. I have two more under the seat that I have to deal with. There's two rusty lines. We'll fix the pinholes on that next, but now this thing can work instead of being worked on, so that's nice. And I'll be working next on the C10. I got it up on the lift. I'm gonna pull the trans real quick. I gotta measure to see if I could put some kind of clutch spacer in there or something, or I don't know, figure something out with that. Because it's a pain. It's really frustrating because the thing runs, it would drive if it would just get put in the gear. So that'll be one of my next videos coming up. And if you like what you saw, hit that thumbs up. If you didn't, hit that thumbs down, that's fine, or just you know, comment and let me know what you would have done or whatever, if you like what you saw. And if you want to see more, just hit that subscribe button. Thanks a lot, guys.